Hi there, it's Liane, and today we're going to be making a button flower spring plant pot. So the materials that you'll need for this are a selection of buttons in different colours, a garden wire, and it's good to have a pair of pliers and a pair of wire cutters, but not essential. You can just use some old scissors and something to decorate the plant pot. I've used an acrylic paint marker, but you could use tissue paper, collaged, paint, whatever you have to hand to decorate. So let's get started. I hope you enjoy the project. To make these stalks for the flowers, if you take ordinary gardening wire, this is covered with plastic, so it's green, but silver wiring would be good as well. And the kind of thickness you need is just something that's going to bend easily enough through the buttons, but is strong enough that when it's twisted together, it will hold up and hold the weight of the buttons for the stem. So I've measured out about 75 centimeters of this wire. I'm then going to bring the ends together and just make sure the wire's running parallel, oops, and just give a little bend at the top, but not so much that it gives a kink in the wire. And this is going to be the top of the stem. So I've laid out the buttons in coordinated colours and size order. These ones I'm starting from small, working up to large, and then working back down to small. And it's between like 8 to 10 buttons is a good amount. So I'm going to take the first button in the row and thread just a single strand of the wire until I reach the point where the wire has got the fold in it. I'm then going to take the front wire and just thread it through the button, keeping a nice curve in the button and just pulling very slowly at this point, so the first button is fastened. Then I'm gonna bend both wires down in the same direction, and I'm gonna twist using the button to anchor the twist. And I find it helpful to look at the back of the twist, and it needs to be about a centimeter. Once I've twisted that much, I'm then going to put the wires together at the end, take the next button in the row and thread through both wires. If you've got a button with four holes, what you could do is put one wire through each hole, again threading from the back so that the button will sit face up, and just gently pull the wire up to the point where the twist stops and just press it flat. Back will look like this. And I'm then going to run those wires parallel through the hole. For about a centimeter. And at this point as well, I like to just straighten up the line so that it's running in a nice straight line, so the stem looks straight once the buttons are on. So take the next button in the row, spools, so I'm gonna thread one through either side, through the back. Press it flat. And thread one at a time through the hole.
larger. I'm going to twist for a little bit longer, between 1.5-2 centimeters, because the button will overlap more of the stem. So just to keep a similar look to it, I'm going to make a larger amount twisted. This button also has 4 holes in it, but because it's a larger button, I'm going to take both of the wires through one hole. And then on the way back down, always do one at a time. They're both going to go through the same hole at a diagonal. So I've got a single.
So I've got about the same amount of stem as I have of decorated button stem. So I'll take this out of the pot. So the way I'm getting them to stay in is I'm just using another bit of wire. Reuse a couple of bits of wire just to make a frame for these to go into, and then just going to bunch them together.
and just lay all the ends of the stems together. I'd say at this point it's more important to get like the height of the buttons more even. Don't worry if the stems are different lengths. And then I'm going to twist that whole bundle together. So these could sit in a vase as well. I'm just going to bend that slightly and then just position them into the pot. And then just takes a bit of arranging to get them to sit. In a way that you're happy with. To decorate the pot, you could use decoupage, collage, paint the pot. I've used this acrylic paint marker and I've just drawn geo patterns over the pot to keep it fairly simple and have the different colours for the buttons be the main feature. So this is the project finished. So I hope you've enjoyed doing this project. I think it's a great way to use buttons and bring a little bit of colour. And thank you very much for taking part in the project. Goodbye.